Hello everyone, my name is Loco and welcome back to some more Overwatch. Now today I'm gonna be playing a good old favorite of mine. Today we're gonna be playing the Justice Rains From Above Brawl. Now just in case if you are unfamiliar with this brawl, which I can totally imagine, we are only gonna be capable of playing with Pharah or with Mercy. So this battle will be taken to the sky. It actually says right here, no tank hero and too many of a single one. I mean, I'm afraid I can't change that. But either way, let's get started with a little bit of Pharah action. Now, in case you've been watching the YouTube channel for a little bit longer than just lately, oh man. I did make a video about this one in the beta of Overwatch as well. Now, sadly, I'm not going to be capable of flying over that. I knew about that. But I did make a video about this brawl as well. In the beta version of Overwatch, they basically were then changing it every single day. But it's such a difficult brawl. As you may can imagine, both of these heroes are gonna be flying around. And that basically means that since Mercy is constantly healing up heroes, we are going for full-on body shots. Now, body shots, really freaking hard. I'm just gonna head towards the objective, though. These guys are flying about and around and whatnot. I don't care. Oh, man. But it's mostly like a wasp's nest, and that's really what caught me, oh man, in the first time and the first iteration of this brawl. Back in the beta of Overwatch, they were changing on the daily instead of on the weekly, and this was actually one of my absolute favorites. Like, it was so much fun to play, even though it's so chaotic and it's such a mess. If you manage to get a kill, it does feel pretty good. Now notice the kill feed, okay, in the top right corner. Generally speaking, you will not be dying very often, but also because of that, the defending team seems to have a air superiority at the very least, because they're simply not gonna be capable of you know, dying. I mean, we keep trying to kill them, right? But because Mercies are around as well, and generally speaking, you're gonna be running with like half Mercy. Oh man, I'm super low. Woo! Generally speaking, you're gonna be running with like half Mercy or with you know, several more Pharahs, and because of that, like, you're gonna have a really hard time trying to take each other out. Now, we still haven't really captured the objective, and that's because they always keep coming back before we even are back, or like, before we're gonna be capable of killing them. Now, lucky for me, just hit a couple once again. But, like, in these fights, right, these fights, you just have to hit the buddy shot. And I'm doing rather well, I'm doing reasonably well at the very least. But I think playing defensive here is gonna be far superior. Now, obviously, we're gonna play a couple games. Gonna go ahead and play some. Ooh. Ooh, man, how was that not a hit? I'm gonna be playing some with Mercy very soon as well, but for the moment, we're gonna try and take it to the skies and hit as many of these guys with body shots as possible. We are currently capturing the objective. We can't, by the way, fly too high either, because otherwise it's not capturing. There we go. At least in the beta, I don't think I won a single one. Well, on the defensive, and I played this for several hours, because I was grinding games. There we go. It's good for your aiming, though. Like, it's good for your aiming skills, but we do finally take a rocket to the face as well. And we do end up falling there. But, I don't know. Not too worried about the scenario. And my allies are actually on the objective, and they managed to just capture it. That's extremely nice done, or extremely well done. Now, one other rule that they've also changed is that the ultimates and the abilities and whatnot all charge up a little bit slower. So, I've only heard of one ultimate thus far in this game, and that's really not that, you know, not that great. I've got you on my radar, but play nice, play Pharah seems to be a pretty cool one. Seems like all of my allies are running to play nice, play Pharah, but here we go. This is where we can fly much higher up. Where we can fly much higher, but this is good for the aiming skills either way, though. But welcome to the wasp's nest. This is where we're flying around, and we're trying to hit each other, but we're all healing up, and only really a headshot will kill, but it's really freaking hard to do that. Obviously, the enemies will now not always, or not also have a little bit of a shorter run back time. They're also gonna be capable of healing themselves up much easier if they just simply fly back for a second. That was a nice hit, though, by the allies, or by the opponent there, nice. All right, we're back. I nearly got my ultimate, although it's charging up real slow. We're nearly there. Ooh. Obviously, if you're using your ulti, you're gonna basically be stationary on the ground. There we go, though. Or not stationary in the air. Little bit scary. I did end up killing someone there because of that. Let's see if we can capture it. Who's holding his back? Oh, man. We're actually getting it. Get him! Like, you can't... Oh, no, 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 no. You can't be too high up in the air either, because then it stops capturing. We did just get a massive portion of it, but I'm a little bit worried. Oh, man. Woo, someone shot a rocket after me. Oh, we got relatively close to it. We're still on it. But like I said, you know, we need to get one of these really sick ulties off once again. There we go, there we go, there we go. Good job, ally. Although you didn't kill anyone, that's a little unfortunate. I think that could have made the difference, but... Oh, man. The rocket barrage are going all over the place. Okay. Still trying to capture it, but I mean, it's going a little bit slowly because everyone's flying a lot like crazy and we're being pushed about because of Vara's E. There we go. Actually, I think that may very well have reduced cooldown. Don't want to be on the ground for too long either because that does become you, or that does make you a very easy target. Obviously, Mercy also is giving like a damage boost and whatnot. There we go. I got a kill. And actually, oh, just as I was about to say, I think we're in a good spot here. I do get taken out. Not without doing sufficient amounts of work, though. Okay, okay, the allies are on it. We did manage to capture 2/3 of it just now. Oh, man. We've got 4 minutes remaining. Obviously, we're going to trigger the overtime for all of eternity here. Whoop, they get a kill just now. Decided to walk back into this little corner here. See if we can make it work. Oh, no. Oh, no. I want to grab heals. I want to grab heals. There we go. See if we can do some work here from a distance. And hopefully, we get an ultimate going again soon enough. That will allow us to... Oh, man. That will allow us to come back into the game and grab the final objective. Thank you very much here. Mercy for the heals. Now, the thing is, obviously, when you have that damage ulti, you can start one-shotting enemies. But you do have to hit him. You do have to hit him with a body shot. I believe a body shot does 130 damage, I think. While it seems to work relatively well, it's still pretty difficult to make it work. Okay, get him. Super low once again, though. A little bit too low for my liking. Gonna see if I can walk back here. Grab myself some additional healing from this little... whatever it is, the health back here in the corner. Oh, man. This is crazy. Thank you very much, healer. How is she not dead? Like, oh, there we go, finally. Okay, here we go, here we go, here we go. Here we go, here we go. Oh, man, they're gonna try and push it. There's only a Mercy. Did get the Mercy here. Group up, group up, group up. There's someone up in the sky, though. They're hitting it like crazy, but we have to stay close to the ground. You have to stay close to the ground in order to capture any kind of progress. Oh, they get another body shield there. Very nice. Oh. We don't want to, like, sit on the ground and be a sitting duck for too long either, but with 60 seconds remaining... I was hoping we would be capable of making it, but I was gonna say, with 60 seconds remaining, I think we can get another ulti. I think we can try and get another ulti off. Ooh! Well, that works. That works. Okay, my ulti is at 80% here. It charges so very slowly. It looks like one of the allies actually just get it. However, there's an ally, or there's an opposing Mercy as well, using their ulti. They're just saving it, man. They're just saving it for the big kill. Overtime is obviously going to be triggering. Okay. Oh, I did as much as I can. The thing is, obviously, once you use your ulti, you're a stationary target. I did as much as I could. Only 10 seconds remaining. No, 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 no. This is not good. This is not good. We have to trade the overtime. I hope someone's on there. Okay, okay, okay. Okay, okay, okay. There we go. Gonna jump back. Gonna jump back. Overtime should be triggered for quite a little while, though, because obviously they're gonna have a very hard time cleaning us up. I don't know how far the ulties are. Mine is not even remotely, you know, ready to go. And this may go on for a little while. We did manage to get 2/3, so one cleanup of the enemy team will net us a victory. I've been doing as much damage here as I possibly can, while trying to be smart about my positioning and all that. Do get another kill there. There we go, there we go, there we go. Okay. See if we can sit on the ground.
I'm sitting on the ground. This is a risk. This is a risk. I'm super low. Nah, I think it does 120 damage. I need healing though. I do get taken out. I do get taken out, but a lot of it is being captured right now. But look at this. Look at this, like wasp's nest. Seriously, it looks like a beehive. Everyone's just buzzing around, trying to do a little bit of work, and none of it is really working out. We're gonna see if we can take the main entrance now instead of like the fastest walk around. I mean, I don't think overtime is gonna go away anytime soon. At the very least, a bunch of my allies are still on there. We're grabbing it, slowly but surely. Oh man, oh man. We'll head back here. We'll head back in this little corner thing. Gotta make sure that I don't die. Okay, okay. Still being contested. Did once again get a butter shield off on me. Yeah, with 120 damage, this is where it's at. Like constantly grabbing those healing globes if you're not getting healed up by Mercy. Does help out a lot, but it's currently overtime. Almost disappearing. Trying to get close to it, but I was out of position there. We should really prioritize killing their healers, but they're so freaking fast. It's so difficult to kill Mercy when she's obviously constantly using her Guardian Angel ability. The overtime is going on though. Did just get another kill on one of their Mercies. But the thing is, like, they're obviously always respawning super quickly, and we're never gonna be able to bring this to a successful end if they keep flying about like this. I mean, they're gonna be able to get back into the fight so very quickly. It only takes them like 6 or 7 seconds before they're back. Whereas for us, it takes like 20. So technically speaking, as long as we're trading evenly, this should go in favor of the opponents. Obviously, hero switching is not gonna be happening here either. So we'll try and see if we can make this, you know, clusterfuck into a successful ending. How is this Mercy not getting a hit off? I hit her like 4 times there, at the very least. See if I can do anything anything of use here on the balcony. Obviously, does make aiming a little bit better. Although, also makes me significantly more vulnerable to these hits. But it looks like none of the allies, including myself, was on the objective. And they managed to grab the game here. Wow, Pharah got to play the game? What a surprise! Never anticipated that one. Look at that. Let's see how many kills she actually managed to get. There we go. Yeah, she's just walking around, aiming for ground. Not even an ulti, actually. That's really well done. That's actually really, really well done. Alrighty then, let's see if we can make Mercy work. This time around, we're on the Temple of Anubis, and apparently one of my allies is talking about why we're not playing a tank. What? Oh man, we got a literal 1 second cooldown on the Guardian Angel ability. That's why they keep flying about. That's crazy. So for anyone wondering, I also have the Angelic Ascent on this hero. That basically means that once you hit spacebar, you're gonna slowly glide towards the ground. And that's one of the ways... that's one of the ways you can get a little bit more vision about what's going on there. Obviously, it also allows Mercy to get... it also allows Vara to really fly about a lot more often, because she also has her shift available constantly. But I guess we'll give it a try. I've picked my buddy over here, known as Alberto. He's gonna get a little bit of a damage boost in it right from the get-go. And the Muffin Lord actually ends up getting a kill. Very nicely done. I'll go ahead and help out Mr. Fake. Ooh, obviously I can switch into my pistol, but I don't think I'm gonna be doing so very often at all. Gotta make sure that I heal up as many of these guys as possible, including the allied Mercies. Everyone's taking some damage at the very least, but... that's gonna be my main goal though. I really wanna see if I can keep everyone alive in high HP. Do need to make sure I can actually catch on with a shift, but the controls are pretty tricky, not gonna lie. This is absolutely mad. I'm just looking for little, like, you know, healing icons and like little low HP marks there. Such as, for example, this Pharah over here. Now, I'm pretty low myself, which makes this rather tricky, but as long as I keep flying and I boost around the allies, we're gonna be okay. Now, this may be one of the few scenarios where having a high DPI or high DPI mouse is pretty helpful. For any one of you nerds that is interested in that, I use 800 DPI and a very, very slow movement speed in-game as well as in Windows. And all in all, I have to drag like mad over my mousepad in order to move my mouse, which usually makes you significantly more accurate. But in this particular case, accuracy is not really what we're looking for. Oh man, they're actually doing a super good job. They're actually doing a super good job of capturing it right now. I mean, I'm trying to head over towards the objective. Hitting my shift or tapping my shift button. Looks like I can't lock onto anyone from there. They just grabbed it. Right? I don't have my ulti. I don't have my ulti. I would have ult-rest them if I could, but I don't have my ulti up. And they do end up grabbing the advantage here, and they will be moving towards B. They've got 8 minutes for that. A little bit of Mercy on Mercy action. That's pretty hot. That was pretty silly. Alrighty, back on the objective. Gotta get back onto the objective. Tell Valhalla! I immediately died here, but I think that's worth it-ish, maybe? They're doing extremely well. They're just moving about here on the objective, trying to do... You know, trying to grab it, and they're doing a mighty good job of it so far. They've got one third of it. 7 minutes remaining, though. I think we can do that. I think we can do that. This point may be easier to capture, though, than the other map that we just played previously, just because... Everyone's flying a little bit lower. Like, Hanamura on B, everyone's flying really high up. I think no matter what here, they're always in range of capturing the objective. Now, they are nearly capturing it, which is a little bit worrisome, not gonna lie. But it looks like they went a little bit overzealous. And I think they're dead. I think they're all dead. Well, not all of them at least, but... But yeah, look at that. Like, we're taking so much splash damage here, and that's mainly because... No one's really flying up nearly as high, making it much easier to hit Pharah. Or making it much easier to hit Mercy. So maybe having two Mercies and three Pharahs does help. Although, apparently one of my allies did just end up switching there. Oh man. No need to go off on your own, Mr. Boy 132. Do have my ultimate once more ready to go though, so that's good. Oh man. There we go. Stop hitting me, guys. I've done nothing wrong. I'm doing an innocent little girl here, flying about and hitting the nerds, but mostly just trying to keep my team alive. I've had this one pistol against pistol, you know, meet earlier on in this game, but other than that, it's been pretty peaceful. Maybe I should just start using my pistol too. No, I shouldn't. Terrible idea. It's really the heals where I shine and not really the, you know, the extra damage, I guess, that it provides. I mean, I can do some additional damage as well to them, which works out, I guess, but... Okay. We'll take a little bit of a breather. Okay, maybe I shouldn't have. I don't really want to rest for a single hero, though. Ideally, we save our ulti for a little bit of bigger of a scenario there. Although, apparently, their Mercy just did. Since, like, ultis charge so very slowly, right? This may be the easier way of dealing with it. He's being healed by several Mercies at once, so there's no way he's gonna die. Nice. We do get the friendly rocket barrage, although I don't think it killed any more than maybe one hero. Mercy, get out of there. Mercy, what are you doing over there? We're supposed to heal up our friends. Still got my ulti here ready to go. I haven't really found a moment for it yet, other than one of the allies dying, but that's not really something I'm too worried for. I currently am a damage boost of us from one of our Mercies. Not entirely sure why he's giving me a damage boost. There we go. Three heals at once. Three heals at once. I think that does relatively well. Constantly there's one dead ally though. Constantly there's one dead ally only, so using an ultimate on that when we're already on B is not that great. But it looks like we've made a good chunk of time thus far. I was a little bit worried that we're gonna be capable of grabbing it at like 6 minutes remaining, but right now, you know, there's 2.5 and they still only got 2/3, and it's actually being, you know, degenerated right now. It's not actually increasing anymore. Although I gotta say, this is pretty tiring to play. Mercy even more so than Pharah. At the very least, we're doing a lot of healing. We got the most healing done, so hey, we're doing something right. Waiting for the entire team to die and go for the play of the game, right? With the Q? Is that the goal here? Maybe not. Okay, use my ulti! 1 minute remaining! gonna be a close one. Six of them are currently on the objective, and all of my allies did just end up falling there. I don't think I've personally ever seen anyone win on the offensive. Although, I don't remember exactly what happened. I just remember it was significantly better to play on the defensive instead. But it looks like the enemy team actually managed to do it. They actually managed to do that. That's really well done by them. I'm gonna be giving them the play of the game. But I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. Obviously, it was a little bit messy, a little bit of something else. I'm thinking that starting next week, we're gonna be getting completely new brawls that we've never seen before, which I'm really looking forward to. But I hope you enjoyed watching this one either way. If you haven't already, hit that like button. If you want to see more content like this, hit that subscribe button. And other than that, I want to thank you all for watching. Have an amazing day. Do not forget to smile. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye! Ooh, we did just level up, by the way. Let's see if we get something useful this time around. No. At least the Zerg portrait. Still no Zerg portrait, sadly.